Hi, you are watching Linux Home Tutorial, and Roshak with you. In this video, I want to demonstrate you how you can easily create bash scripts in Dolphin. My problem is that every time I need a new script, I am doing the same actions, which really annoys me. Now let's imagine this folder is my new projects folder, and when I am creating a new script, I am going to create new text file. Let's name it my script, for example. .sh. Now I'm opening this file, writing some stuff such as shebang, some meta info, a description of a script's purpose. And actually the code, for example, some echo command. Now I'm saving a script, and when coding I want to launch this script here in a terminal panel, but I'm unable to do so until I enable execution permissions. If I directly run this script, I got a permission error. So either I need to run it by implicit invoking it with interpreter, or I need to go to the file properties and add execution permission, and only after that I'm able to directly run it. And I need to do all of this every time I create a new script, and I'm creating scripts very often. And I thought if it is possible to add my script to this create new menu. And the answer is yes, it is very easily possible. All you need to do is just install a new service menu called KDE5 Template Manager. As you can see, I've already installed it. Press install here. Now, how to use it? You need to right click on a file you want to use as a template, then go to actions, manage templates, create template from this object. Let's name it bash shark. Here I can create a more descriptive text that will be displayed when creating a new file. For example, I'll use such description. I'm pressing OK. Now I need to choose an icon. If I search for bash, I can see there is no such icon, but if I search for shell, I can use this icon, and I got a message that template was created successfully. Now let's use it. For example, now I want to create a new script here again. I'm right clicking here, create new, and as you can see, my template is here. I'm clicking it. Here I can set its name. Let's name it, for example, script2.sh. And as you can see, I can directly run it right now without needing to manually add in execution permissions, because it is already here. And now I wanted to demonstrate to you that you can also perform such actions as editing or deleting a template. For example, I'll show you how to delete this new template. I'm going to actions, manage templates, delete, remove existing templates. Here I can select a template, press OK, and just confirm that I want to do this. Now I get a message that it was removed, and as you can see, it is no more here. So that's it for today. I hope this was useful for you. If so, don't forget to press like button, and goodbye for now.